Alright, let's get started. So tonight I'm just going to be cleaning up sort of these edges in here a little bit, kind of making sure that the grooves between the blocks looks more natural, make sure there's no weird overlapping or any areas where the line is kind of hidden by different things. So we'll just be working on that tonight, doing some quick cleanups, and then these blocks should almost be finished. So for instance, like right here. Just peel away some of that edge, kind of make it a little bit more slanted. Making sure that these are a little bit more even. This one's a little too high, so I'm just going to pull this one down a little bit. Thicken, make this one a little bit wider. So we can just go into our deformation. Make sure we've got Y turned off. Sure to set my quick save back to 5 minutes. Just hold this one back some more. Thank you. That one's probably a little bit too far out, so I'm just going to pull it back in a little bit. Mainly I'm focused on what it looks like when the camera's pulled back, so you can see like how these grooves are nice in here, but then this one kind of comes off flat, so I'm just going to alt select this one, sculpt out this bottom part a little bit. And you can see how that right there looks better than it does right here, so we just want to continue that. I don't really care what it looks like down here because this will all be covered up anyways, won't come through in the bake, won't come through in the low poly, so it doesn't matter if I mess all this up. A little bit more right here. Thank you. So that looks better. It looks like there's an actual break there now. This one's kind of floating right here, so I'm gonna wanna kind of fix that. In fact, this one, oops, went a little too far. This one right here is probably a little bit too sunken down, so you can kind of see how it's coming through that, so I'm just gonna pull this one up. This one might actually be a little bit too small, so I can scale it up. I actually want to do scale this one up in Y. These quick saves are a little bit long, but just part of it. Better than it crashing and me losing a whole bunch of stuff. Not rotate on size. So you can see, like right here, this looks a little weird because this block is kind of probably slanted a little bit, and so I'm just going to carve this one out a little. This is sort of one of the nice things of just duplicating these and reusing them, is I saved a lot of time not having to sculpt every single one, and then I can just go back in and kind of make adjustments on the fly as needed. And it gives it some, you know, a little bit more customization, because now I'm sculpting so that stuff kind of fits together, so it creates a more natural, realistic look to it. Rotate that one a little bit so it's not so extreme. this one back a little bit. Probably sharpen up this edge a little bit too. You know, these grooves will be really important when it comes to the normal map bake and the AO bake, so I want to make sure they look good before we commit to anything. You know, you want to make sure there's enough of a difference between the two surfaces so that when it bakes, the normal map doesn't get sort of blended all into one. Just move these two a little bit away from each other. Peel some of this down. Actually, I'll probably peel this one up. Just pull this one down a little bit. two right here kind of like colliding in with each other. So let's see. I'll just peel back the edge on this one. Because I have this one selected on a separate subtool, I can edit it with the other ones still actually turned on without having to worry about messing them up. Hey, sorry Tinian, just noticed your message, I had something covering it actually. I do use Unreal 4. This whole environment's gonna get built in Unreal 4. As for Blender, no, I don't actually use Blender, I use Maya 2016 for everything. Syrup are a little bit too close together, they're kind of like merging in, so I'm just going to pull this one over a little bit. And maybe actually rotate this one a little bit. A little bit better. What program is this? This is zBrush that I'm currently using. I'm not too worried about if there's gaps between it. When we do the normal and we do the textures, I can just make that look like, you know, there's just some dirt or something built up inside there. It's not too big of a deal. With this kind of sculpting, it's kind of impossible to fill up every little, you know, gap and hole between the different pieces. I do want to make sure that none are floating though, like this is right now. Make this one taller a little bit. A good free program. Blender does have a sculpting element to it. I've never actually used it. I think it's pretty good from what I've heard. You know, it could do some of this stuff. But there's sort of like a lot of tools and things that are very unique to ZBrush that, you know, you could probably get around using in some of the other programs. Yeah, it's not a cheap program. It's I'm really hoping when they come out with ZBrush 5 that they do this sort of you know, pay $10 a month or something like that rather than the one-time $800, because that is quite expensive. This is kind of a big gap right here, so I'm actually just going to size this one up a little bit, and I think this is going to be X. Nope, I was wrong, it's Z. Yeah, ZBrush is it's a pretty important program to the artist pipeline. But yes, it's a very hefty cost. Gonna sculpt this edge out right here on this one. But I mean, mainly, ZBrush is really good for two things, and that's characters and sort of organic environment art. Personally, I like sticking to something like Maya for weapons, vehicles, hard surface, things like that. I move much faster in Maya than I do in ZBrush, so I just prefer those. Back edge, flatten this out a little bit to give it more depth. I think all this looks pretty good. A little bit here needs to get fixed. I think just right here, and this side will be done. Actually, this looks okay when I get closer. Just need to fix up this. Yeah, zBrush and crashing is a it's a pretty common occurrence. Especially running OBS when I'm streaming it, both programs are taking up a lot of computing power, so. So I'm going to cut this one back a little bit. I want to make it appear that there's that groove there and that they're not just flat sitting on top of each other, so it bakes that normal map out nicely. Thanks for the follow, Yukifax. Probably just right here, these little bit of tips right here just need to get pulled back. Any of that spam crap in here? Guess we're getting all the spam bots tonight. Alright, so this bottom part looks good. I just need to fix up right up here. Alright guys, that's my stream for tonight. I gotta call it early. Thanks everyone who tuned in and for the follows tonight. As always, you can catch all of my previous work over on YouTube. There's a link below. Be finishing up these blocks next time, then we'll be moving on to the top, then just some final touch-up and we'll be done with this pillar. So yeah, hope you guys...